Hello students, so here I am with a new chapter, that is current electricity. So in this chapter we will see the different subtopics here, that is electric current, what is the direction of electric current, one by one, right? So in the previous chapter in electrostatic, I have just given a basic concept and you need to solve numericals. So in between these days or coming week I will be solving some numericals of that chapters also. Till then you will be preparing notes for this chapter, that is current electricity, and hopefully you have written notes of previous chapter which I have given in a PDF files, and also the numericals you need to do. So electric current, you see, whenever there is a flow of free electrons, so there is a production of electricity. That means electric current is due to the flow of electrons from one terminal to another. It is wise to say that electric current does not have any direction because it is a scalar quantity. So most of the time we get confused with the direction of electric current. Generally we say that is from positive terminal to the negative terminal in the junior classes which we have learned. But electric current is a scalar quantity which don't have any direction, and the reason behind it is that it does not obey vector law of addition. So for this reason we consider electric current to be an scalar quantity, not to be a vector quantity. So you see, a conductor is connected with one battery. So this battery, this is a positive terminal, this is a negative terminal, and we have electrons here. So when it is connected with a battery, you see all the electrons get moved towards the positive terminal. Okay, and all the positive ions which are there in the conductor, they move towards the negative terminal. So generally we say that electric current is due to the flow of electrons, that is towards the positive terminal, and that is the direction of electron current. And conventional current is opposite to the direction of electrons. Now if I say, so from positive to negative, that is the flow of positive charge, that is called conventional current. And from negative to positive, that is the electronic current. So what is electric current then? Electric current states that rate of flow of charge per unit time. That means the number of charges flowing per unit time we consider to be as electric current. Now when I say a small amount of charge passing through a unit area in small time t, then we consider this has to be as average current. Okay, that is, we can sometimes we consider it as instantaneous current also. So electric current, when I say that is the rate of flow of charge per unit time, is said to be as electric current, and that is q by t is the form of electric current here. As a unit of electric current is ampere, and 1 ampere equals to 1 coulomb by 1 second. Now how you are going to define 1 ampere? If it is asked, what is 1 ampere? That means we will be saying here, when 1 coulomb of charge is passing through a unit area in 1 second, the total magnitude of current is said to be as 1 ampere. That means you see, when Q, that is 1 coulomb of charge is passing through a unit area in 1 second, then the quantity of current, that magnitude of current, is said to be as 1 ampere. And also, already I have said that current is a scalar quantity, because it does not obey the law of vector addition. Okay, so conventional direction of current is taken to opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. That is the conventional current, when I say that is the flow of positive charge towards the negative terminal. Okay, that is the opposite to the direction of flow of electrons, because we know electrons flows from negative to positive. So conventional current flows from positive to negative, that is the flow of positive ions. So these are the points that is related to the electric current here, just the basic points here. Now when I say the types of electric current, now there can be two types of electric current. One is direct current and one is AC current, that is alternating current. Direct current, when I say, that is magnitude and direction remains same. That means there is no change any magnitude and direction of that current. That is, it is a steady current. But when I say AC current, that is alternating current, that means it changes its magnitude and direction periodically. Now when I take it in graph, will see that if I plot in terms of time, and this is the current, right? This is the magnitude of current. So for direct current, we'll be getting a straight line. You see, the magnitude is same. But whereas for alternating current, we'll find that it changes its direction and magnitude periodically. That means again, it will move like this, right? So its magnitude will remain same. But here, sometimes it is increasing and sometimes it is decreasing. That means the magnitude is not same in each and every point of time. That means if I consider the different time intervals here, at this time interval, this is the current. At this time interval, this is the current. So that means the time interval and the current magnitude is changing in case of AC current. But in case of direct current, the magnitude and direction of current remains same. So this is the basic difference between the direct current and alternating current. Okay. Now you see, what is current density? Current density is denoted by J. So to understand the strength of electric current flowing through a given area, so we calculate it by current density. So current flowing per unit area is the current density. Okay. So current density is defined as the ratio of electric current flowing per unit area A. And you see, to know what its SI unit, what will be its SI unit, just we'll find the units of each term. Like means current we say ampere, and this is in meter square, right? So current density we can write it as ampere per meter square. So this is how we calculate the SI unit of a unknown terms. So you see here, the current can be steady current, varying current and alternating current, right? So just now I said that if the electric current has a magnitude and the direction of electric current is same, that is the direction of flow of electron is constant, then we say that is a steady current or the direct current. But if the magnitude changes with time and the current is called varying current, that is magnitude changes. See here, only the magnitude of the current is getting changed. So this is an example of varying current. So one more current is there, that is varying. The current is varying here. When a capacitor is connected to a cell, the capacitor gets charged, and the current flowing through the capacitor during charging is an example of varying current. Okay, so this is the diagram. You see, the current is here is steady, that is the steady current here, and after the capacitor is getting charged, you see two parallel conductors. So this is a capacitor that is charged by a battery. So the current flowing through the capacitor will be this nature. So this is the varying current and this is the alternating current. You see, the direction and magnitude is changing periodically. So these are the three types of charges. In the basically we have learned in the junior classes only two types, that is alternating current and direct current, and here we have one more term, that is a varying current. So based on this we have some numericals here. You see, through a certain cross section of metal wire, 5 × 10^20 electrons drift in 20 seconds. Calculate the current. The charge of electron is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. So number of electrons is given. Time is also given. So we need to calculate electric current. So electric current we know, I equals to Q by T. So Q equals to any. From the first chapter we know that is the quantization of charge. So in place of Q we will substitute here any, you see. So Ne by T, and we will substitute the value of N and the value of charge of an electron and time, then we will get the electric current. Similar numericals we have here. So this all you need to copy in your exercise book. So you with the same formula. Okay, just we need to apply here. This I equals to Ne by T. Thermal velocities, like you see, when there is a gas molecules and whenever any electric field is passing through those gas molecules, the ions, they try to move randomly in all directions. They move with one velocity. That velocity is considered to be as thermal velocity. That is what is here. You see, like the gas molecules, the conduction electrons move in all directions with all possible velocities, and that velocities of that electrons is considered to be as thermal velocity. Generally, you see, whenever any gas molecules are in a jar, that gas molecules, the particles, they try to move randomly in all possible direction, and they move with one velocity, and due to which what the temperature of the gas molecules striking the surface becomes heated up, and due to increase in temperature again the velocity of the gas molecules increases. So here you see the thermal velocity is very large and is of order of 10 to the power 6 meter per second. That is the velocity of that electrons, that is the gas molecules, is very large here, and it increases with the increasing temperature. As I have said here, first when the electrons in of that gas molecules, when they try to go and move here and there in all possible direction, they strike the outer vessel, and after striking they again collide with the other electrons, and repeatedly the temperature of that gas molecules gets increases with increasing thermal velocity. But when I say what is the average thermal velocity, that remains zero, because average velocity passing through a given unit area is always zero. The average velocity acquired by free electrons in a conductor subjected to an electric field is called drift velocity. That means if you connect a conductor with an electric field, the metal ions, the positive ions, will move towards the negative terminal, and the electrons in that conductor will move towards the positive terminal. Due to an application of external field in that conductor, the electrons or the positive ions, they get drifted to its opposite terminal. So this is called drift velocity. Okay, that means this was the conductor. This conductor was connected with one battery, one source. Here the electrons inside the conductor will get drifted towards the positive terminal. That is why the word used here, that is drift. Okay, the electrons inside the conductor will get drifted towards the positive terminal, and the positive ions will get drifted towards the negative terminal. Next, you see, we know this equation V equals to U plus AT, right? So this is the velocity time relation. If you remember that Newton's law of motion, in that chapter we have learned in the junior classes, V equals to U plus AT. Now when I say V, that is VD, that is the drift velocity, and U is the initial velocity. In that case, here we have average initial velocity of the electrons in the conductor, plus here A is acceleration, here we will consider as alpha, and T we will consider as tau. Tau means here relaxation time, where alpha is here acceleration. It is just the denotation, then terms has got changed. Okay, so average velocity of the electrons inside a conductor before connecting the electric field, before connecting the battery, the electrons or the ions which are there inside the conductor is considered to be as zero. So average velocity, just now I have said that the average thermal velocity is zero. So similarly here, the average initial velocity of the electrons inside the conductor is considered to be as zero. So we will get Vd equals to 0 plus alpha tau. Also we know F equals to Ma, that means M alpha, or alpha can be written as M, F by M. And in electrostatic chapter we have seen the force of on any electron, that is given by QE. And here charge is the electron, that is small e by M. So what is alpha here? E, capital E by M. Now when you will substitute here, we will get the expression for drift velocity. So drift velocity is equal to alpha, but what is alpha here? E, capital E by M tau. Okay, so this is the expression for drift velocity, and it is the order of 10 to the power minus 6 meter per second, and this is very small. Thermal velocity which we have seen, that was 10 to the power 6 meter per second, but in case of drift velocity, here it is 10 to the power minus 6 meter per second. Now when the electric field is zero, that means when you are not connecting that conductor, any conductor with any battery, then electrons will not get drifted to the opposite terminals. That means they will be moving in their metals or within their surface only. They will not get drifted towards the opposite terminal. So in that case, drift velocity will also be zero. So if electric field is zero, so drift velocity is also zero. And drift velocity decreases with increasing temperature. But in case of thermal velocity, when we are increasing the temperature, the thermal velocities were also increasing. But here, in this case, in drift velocity, with increasing temperature, the velocity gets decreases, and the expression states that Vt equals to E capital E by m, where E is the magnitude of charge, capital is the electric field, m is the mass of an electron, and tau is the relaxation time. Now when I say what is the relaxation time again, so it is a time interval between two successive collision of electrons. If in the conductor, here you see I have connected this conductor with one battery. Now electrons, those who are near to the conductor, they will get easily drifted towards the positive terminal. But the electron which is here at the other end, this electron will get collide with this electron. This electron will get collide with the successive electron. So like this, the time interval or the time gap between the two successive collision of electrons is said to be as relaxation time, right? So if relaxation time is very less, then we consider to be as drift velocity will also get changed. So next we see that what is the mobility. Now drift velocity per unit electric field is said to be as mobility. Now if I ask you what is the mobility of electron and proton, that means which is mobile, that means which can move easily, whether it's the positive charge or the electrons, that means electrons mobility is very more as compared to that of positive charge. Okay, so and it depends upon the mass also and the electric field which is applied. So mobility is denoted by mu equals to drift velocity per unit electric field. So drift velocity per unit electric field is termed as mobility. So on the board you can see I have derived one expression for drift velocity in terms of electric current. So this is a very important question in terms of board. You see, they ask what is the relation between drift velocity, that is Vd and I. Okay, so the expression is I equals to NEA Vd. So we are going to derive this expression. Okay, so first we see I have considered one here conductor of length L. Let us consider the area of cross section is A and the number of electrons inside this conductor to be as N. Okay, so volume of the conductor, when I say that is A into L, A means area, that is a meter square, and L is the length, that is meter. So meter square into meter, that is meter cube. So that is why I have considered the volume of a conductor to be as L. And total number of electrons, so as I have said the number of electrons is N, so we will consider N into L. So number of electrons into total volume is the total electrons. And charge, we know Q equals to NE. So total number of electrons, that is this is the total N. So N into E, that is Q equals to NE. Q equals to NE, we know this from first chapter. So what is N here? This N is the total NAL, right? So total electrons. This total electrons multiplied by E will give the total charge. Again we know electric current is defined as rate of flow of charge, that is charge per unit time. Charge means NEALE and time is what? T. Now velocity equals to distance displacement by time, or the distance by time you can consider it as here drift velocity. Okay, so NEA as it is, and this is what? Drift velocity. Or drift velocity can be written as I by NEA. So this is another expression. And the drift velocity in terms of current density, if I say what is the relation between current density and electric field, or in that electric current here, that is I equals to NEVD, A and A will get cancelled, we will get NEVD. So this is an expression for current density. So current density equals to NEVD, electric current equals to NEVD, and VD equals to I by NEA. So this is very important derivation in this chapter. So Ohm's law, we know that flow of electric current through a given conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the two ends of the conductor. Okay, in that case the physical condition has to be same, that is the temperature and pressure. If it is remaining same, the flow of electric current passing through any conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference. So this was Ohm's law, which we have learned in the smaller classes. So this is Ohm's law. The steady current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference between its ends when the physical condition like temperature, mechanical strain, etc. remain
constant. So I is directly proportional to V, or if that proportional sign gets vanished, then we'll get R, that is a resistance. So V equals to IR, or R equals to VYI, where R is the resistance, that is the opposition to the flow of current is called resistance. So you see here, this graph denotes the flow of current with respect to potential difference. So if potential difference is increasing, so current is also increasing, so we are getting a straight graph. Okay, so but for other, like for semiconductors and all, we will be getting non-ohmic graph. So this is an ohmic graph, and we will also be getting a non-ohmic graph in case of semiconductor. So what is electrical resistance? Electrical conductors oppose the flow of electrons passing through them. This opposition arises due to the collision of moving charges with the vibrating atoms, defect in the crystal lattice, impurity atoms, etc. So what basically, what is electric resistance? Electrical resistance, that is opposition to the flow of electric current, is called electrical resistance, and that arises due to collision between electrons and the positive ions inside the conductor. So when there is a collision between positive ions and the electrons, there is a rise of resistance, the opposition.
So according to Ohm's law, V is directly proportional to I, where V equals to IR, or R equals to V by I. Right? So R is the resistance, that is opposition to the flow of current, is called here resistance, whose SI unit is Ohm. Okay? And this is the potential difference, whose unit is volt, and I we know that is ampere. Also we know this resistance depends upon four factors. That means R is directly proportional to length, that means if length will increase, then resistance will increase. Resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section, that means if increase in area, decreases the resistance. And it depends upon the nature of the material, directly proportional to nature of the material. Okay, so these are the three factors upon which it depends. Also it depends upon temperature. So when I include all these, that is length and area, then we will get that rho equals to L by A. So R equals to rho L by A. So that means rho, that is the resistivity. Here rho is considered to be as resistivity, which has come after the removal of this proportionality sign. So it depends upon three factors. Also it depends upon fourth factor, that is the temperature. We know if the temperature will increase, then the resistance will get vary. So increasing temperature increases the resistance, and decreasing temperature decreases the resistance in case of metals here. Okay, so these are the factors upon which electrical resistance depends. Also we know that is the conductivity, that is conductance, that is the reciprocal of resistivity, is called here conductivity. So these are the terms. I will be giving notes of this also in the PDF file. You need to copy in your exercise book, right students? Also the terms which I have explained on the board, the derivations and all, this also you need to write in your exercise book. So see you all in next video tutorial. Okay.